This has got to be the...
It can't be.
This has got to be the draft pick. It's got to be.
Oh, man. Down draft pick. Muhammad,
I guess it's a package deal. Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what. If Muhammad is the draft pick, he will be the most unwelcome draft pick in history. Bar none.
I don't disagree with that, but I'm shocked here.
We're not the only ones that are shocked.
He's got to be the guy. It's got to be the draft pick.
Look at the looks on the faces of the superstars in the ring. They're shocked.
This is unbelievable. Here I am, the newest and greatest Raw Draft Lottery pick. And again, Teddy, again, I'm treated like a second-class citizen. Because if anybody deserves to be named the new SmackDown champion, it is definitely the great Muhammad Hassan. Because in case you guys didn't know, I am the owner of the longest and most prestigious undefeated streak in WWE history. And instead of getting a championship, or even the proper special welcome that I so rightfully deserve, I'm forced to sit in that dungeon that you call an office like I'm something to be ashamed of. Well, maybe you are ashamed of me, Teddy. Maybe all of you guys are ashamed to have me on your show. And why? Why? Because I'm Arab American? Because of the way I dress? Because of the way I talk? Is it because I'm different than all of you? Well, you know what? You guys are right. I am different. Because I'm better than each and every single one of you. Chris Benoit, Mr. Crippler. You never beat me on Raw. Booker T. Mr. Five-time WCW champion. Well, I think you're a five-time loser. Big Show, what about you? Some giant. I could beat you any night of the week. And JBL, as far as I'm concerned, you are just like any other typical American. A big quitter. Now, Teddy Long, I want what I deserve, and I want it right now.
Let's get one thing straight, player. Now, I don't know whether you deserve this or not, but this ain't Raw, player. This is SmackDown, the land of opportunity. So I tell you what, I'm gonna add you to the mix. So next week, it will be a six-man elimination match for the SmackDown championship right here. You feeling that?
Oh! Oh, well, world champion. Oh, looking for the takedown. Hey. And Chris Benoit.
I knew this is about to happen. And Benoit's all over. Welcome to SmackDown.
And now the big show, and there it comes.
Guevara's caught up there. Look at him over there.
And Guevara is caught.
Uh-oh. Oh, oh my God.
Oh, look at the strength of the big show.
Oh, my God.
And Guevara planted on Muhammad.
Wow. Welcome to SmackDown, guys.
Hey, Muhammad. Muhammad, there's one other thing, Blair. Now, you think that your SmackDown debut should be real special? Well, I agree, Blair. Now, earlier you said that you could beat this man any night of the week. So, coming up next, it will be Muhammad Hassan one-on-one with the Big Show!
Next! That's what he said, he said next!
Oh my goodness gracious!
I think Hassan wishes he stayed on
the road. Yeah, I don't think Hassan ever faced anyone like the Big Show one-on-one, that's for sure.
Big Show versus Muhammad Hassan!
I mean, whoopee-doo. Say it again. Whoopee-doo.
All right.
Taz.
Okay. Whoopee-doo. Oh, oh, man. 500 pounds. Uh-oh. Back it up. Uh-oh. That is a 500-pound shoulder block.
Wait a minute.
Guevara at the end.
Oh, he goes bump out. My God, Guevara.
What the hell is he doing?
Guevara just jumped out of his chair like a... Oh, my God, I don't know what the hell he's doing.
Oh, wait a minute. He's got a... Matt Morgan's got a steel chair in hand.
What's he doing?
I have no idea.
Oh, they... What goes up? Box chops
up! Oh, my God! But look at Hassan!
Watch out! That's Muhammad Hassan!
With a steel chair! On the skull! On the skull of the Big Show! Oh, Big Show somehow is still on his feet!
Watch out!
Look at that! Oh, the chair driven into the throat!
Under his throat! Under his throat the chair went!
And here's the cover! Referee Nick Patrick didn't see any of it! Coming
man.
To!
First appearance on SmackDown.
Here is your winner, Muhammad Hassan.
First appearance on SmackDown, he's a winner. Defeats the Big Show.
You gotta be kidding me.
This is impossible. He shot himself.
Oh, Matt Morgan brought the chair in, and Hassan used the chair to his advantage.
The referee, Nick Patrick, was down, and he didn't see anything.
The bottom line is, next week, if Hassan had defeated the Big Show like that, he still has to eliminate four other men in that six-way elimination matchup in order to win the SmackDown Championship.
Wait a minute, you mean to tell me that this man, Muhammad Hassan, can actually be the new SmackDown Champion?
Hassan, wow. Or Big Show, or Benoit, or JBL, or Booker T, or The Undertaker. One of those six men, next week, here on SmackDown, will become the new SmackDown Champion.
Wow, what a win for Muhammad, though. Like it or not, excellent win.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Guevara and Muhammad Hassan.
Welcome to SmackDown from the sold-out Arrowhead Pond in Anaheim, California. And here is Muhammad Hassan, the latest draft pick to come from Raw to SmackDown. And speaking of draft picks, Taz, tonight, two superstars will come to SmackDown from Raw as the draft lottery concludes here tonight on SmackDown.
Sounds good to me, Cole. Who is it gonna be? Who? Which two? Who's coming from Raw? That's what I wanna know. But I can't wait. Tonight we're gonna find out who the new SmackDown champion's gonna be.
And what an impact Muhammad Hassan made last week here on SmackDown. Muhammad Hassan defeating the Big Show last week.
Absolutely. And then you see the draft lottery continues, and that's huge. I mean, doing that, getting that victory over the largest athlete in the world.
Also, Muhammad Hassan, part of that five-man elimination matchup tonight to crown a new SmackDown champion. No respect being shown by the SmackDown fans for Muhammad Hassan here.
Well, they don't like him on SmackDown. I don't either.
This weekend, all of you people and people all across America will be going to camps, taking time off of work, lighting sparklers, firecrackers for the 4th of July. America's Independence Day. Well, growing up here in America as an Arab American, I have a slightly different perspective on the day that you call my Independence Day. You know, I think it's funny, and I think it's ironic that America spends a whole day, dedicates a whole day to the thought of equality for men. Independence, well, I don't feel like a free man. Do you feel like a free man right now? In front of all this tyranny, do you feel like a free man? No, do you feel like a free man when you walk through the airports and you feel people stare at you? No, do you feel like a free man right now with all these people's icy glares on the back of our heads like we did something wrong? No, I don't feel like a free man. No, I've never felt like a free man. I felt like a prisoner in my own country, and damn it, I'm not gonna take it anymore. You people have no idea what it's like to be me, to step in my shoes. But it ends tonight. It ends tonight. Because tonight, when I win the five-way elimination match and become SmackDown champion, I will be on top of the world, looking down on all of you like you've looked down on me and my people for so many years. Because in case you didn't see it last week, I single-handedly took down the 7-foot, 500-pound Big Show right in the middle of the ring. By myself, I am still undefeated, and I will stay undefeated. Just look at who I'm facing. JBL, Booker T, Chris Benoit, The Undertaker. Come on, people. The Undertaker lost 2 weeks ago to JBL. So as far as I'm concerned, he does not deserve to be in this match. People, the day of the dead man has come and gone. You're looking at the new icon, the great Muhammad Hassan.
Oh my! Oh. Be careful who you call out and who you mention. I beg to differ with Mr. Hassan. I don't believe the day of the dead man is come and gone. I believe the day of the dead man is here and now.
No doubt about it. Look at this sight. Oh, man, you got to feel this. It sends goosebumps up your spines, Cole. Just unbelievable the presence the dead man brings.
I believe The Undertaker may indeed be the odds-on favorite in this five-man elimination matchup here tonight on SmackDown to crown a new SmackDown champion. Hassan can say what he wants. JBL can call himself Mr. SmackDown, but I believe you're looking at the real Mr. SmackDown, The Undertaker, on his way to the ring.
Well, that remains to be seen, but what I'm looking at is the most just an evil-looking dead man. Look at the eyes right now on Undertaker. And this guy here at the bottom, he's wearing a white suit. That might not be good for national TV, folks.
And just to bring everybody up today, this was supposed to have been a six-man elimination matchup tonight. But of course, Big Show, victim of the draft lottery on Monday, now on Raw, has made this a five-man elimination. matchup. Undertaker, JBL, Booker T, Chris Benoit, and of course that man, Muhammad Hassan.
Hassan might not make it to that match later on tonight for the SmackDown Championship. Who knows what's gonna go down here with the dead man and Muhammad Hassan. Watch this, watch this.
It's absolutely bone-chilling.
I don't think Muhammad Hassan has ever felt something like this.
Well, I believe this is the first time that Hassan has stood in the presence of the legend, The Undertaker. For Hassan to come out here tonight and say that the day of the dead man is
fucking done. You guys gotta have a death wish. What? I'm shocked, but Hassan, he's not backing down. I just hate to do it. Gotta give him a little credit. Well, speaking of not backing down, that's the fire.
I knew one of them was thinking about running.
Freaked out, Cole. I don't blame him.
Just slow down. Just wait 1 second. You know, I'm actually glad you came out here. I am. Maybe you're not like all of these Americans. Maybe you do have some guts. Maybe you will confront your problems face to face. I mean, when I said the day of the dead man had come and gone, what I was really saying was, you've had one of the most legendary careers in WWE history. I mean, you've beaten everybody on the list. I mean, everybody, all the greats. Except for me. The great Muhammad Hassan.
Oh! And look at the fly with a steel chair in the back, and it hardly moved the Undertaker.
You're not kidding.
And Muhammad Hassan
just got cracked with that chair on the take, and it didn't face.
Uh-oh! Oh, man! Guevara's in trouble, man! Look at this, Cole!
Guevara in all kinds of trouble!
Wow. Message sent, Cole, loud and clear to Muhammad Hassan.
And now Benoit with a chop of his own. JBL's had enough, but here comes Hassan.
Taking Hassan, and Hassan's not happy about it.
And Chris Benoit, the rabid Wolverine, just measuring his man, and Hassan's already taken a lot of punishment in this matchup. Lock up center of the ring, Muhammad Hassan kicked to the midsection. Nice duplex by Hassan on Benoit. Here's the cover and a kick out. All six men still remain in this elimination matchup to crown the new SmackDown champion. Can we get the edge to anybody so far?
Here's the cover again
on Benoit, who kicks out.
Benoit looked impressive on JBL, but now Hassan is controlling Chris Benoit. This thing could go anyway, Cole. Who the hell knows who's going to end up new SmackDown champion? Oh, go behind.
Chris Benoit. Nice block by Muhammad Hassan.
Beautiful block. Stuck the elbow. Watch the throw here.
Wow.
From Northern Lights.
And here's the bridge by Benoit. Hassan just got the shoulder out.
Textbook Northern Lights suplex by Chris Benoit. Very impressive. Now, if you're Hassan, this is what you don't want to do. You never want to give Benoit an inch of an edge or an opening. He will jump right through that opportunity and just take it.
Oh. And Hassan,
look at this
section. Muhammad Hassan would love to prove a lot here.
Whoa,
tonight.
Wow.
Oh, and what a throw by Benoit.
Again, another German suplex. Hassan landing hard on his upper spinal area there. Oh man, look.
Oh my.
Hassan looking into the eyes of the, oh my God.
That makes the Undertaker legal.
Yeah, I know.
Oh. Hassan with a hook on his own. An Undertaker going after Muhammad Hassan here.
Oof. The button. Oh, man, look at this again. Look at the elbow. Oh, my God. Just pounding.
Undertaker throwing hands. Good authority. Dropping Hassan to his knees.
Fast in this guy's hands.
Undertaker is completely lost in here.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Hassan crawling away.
Yeah, Undertaker's in hot pursuit. What the hell?
Steel chair in hand.
Watch out. Oh!
Boot to the face.
Undertaker just dropping Hassan. Oh, my God.
Undertaker, steel chair in hand.
Careful, Undertaker's blown his cork. Watch out.
Oh, floored by a blow with that steel chair.
Wait a minute.
Undertaker.
As a result of a disqualification, the Undertaker has been eliminated.
Oh! So Undertaker has been disqualified. Muhammad Hassan, I believe, is out of this match as well as he heads toward the back. Four superstars remain. Who will be crowned SmackDown champion? The match continues.
I have been humiliated and disgraced for the last time. You see, it's my destiny to liberate the World Heavyweight title and have it sit around the waist of an American of Arab descent.
Well, if you wanted that championship so bad, player, why did you run from The Undertaker last week? Explain that.
Hey, Muhammad Hassan is here.
Mami Femen. In that six-man match, I was never pinned and I never submitted. So technically, I wasn't eliminated. And technically, I deserve the number one contendership against Batista. I deserve justice. I demand justice.
I don't take any demands, player. But you know something? You're right.
Hey.
Now I'm about to lose my religion. Now I don't speak that language, but it seems to me that you feel that something's not fair here.
Yeah, that's about right.
Well, tell you what, Tavare, how about tonight? I put you in a match.
Fine.
You will go one-on-one with The Undertaker. I think you need to get ready, player. Holla.
No. I know you're nervous, but you have to understand your role. Tonight, you will be a sacrifice, but a sacrifice for the greater good, our plan, and Daivari. I assure you that that sacrifice will not go without its reward.
Muhammad, man, name your name, man, Jabba.
Stop. Bamangushkon.
Nah, man, name your name, Jabba, Undertaker.
Bamangushkon.
It's forever. So the Undertaker, he's staring at Hassan, the man he meets at the Great American Bash. And you got that number one contenders matchup.
You got to figure that Undertaker saying that's got to be wearing on Daivari's mind right now.
As Daivari gingerly makes his way into the ring.
You might want to lose that ginger in his gingerly step, because it's going to be a nasty fight that he's in about 2 seconds.
Undertaker's opponent's Daivari, but his eyes trained on Hassan a few moments ago. And Daivari said, you know what, I don't think I'm quite up to the task here tonight. A little breather to start.
Hassan just said it's part of the plan. I can't believe he just threw his old man in there.
I can't believe this. The sacrificial lamb, as you called Daivari earlier.
Daivari's gonna go for a big ride here!
Undertaker was staring at Hassan. This is a message to you, Muhammad Hassan, from The Undertaker.
Hassan could care less that his man just got driven damn near through the ring.
Undertaker continues to look at his opponent.
Oh man, Cole.
Oh my!
Tombstone.
Oh my!
Looking right at Muhammad Hassan!
Tombstone Piledriver!
Talk about a sacrifice.
The cover! It is over! The Undertaker impressive, but an emotionless...
Here's your winner, The Undertaker!
Why is Muhammad Hassan smiling and grinning? What is he doing?
Hell.
What the hell is this?
Who the hell is this?
Two guys in masks.
Wait, what the hell is going on here?
There ain't a third guy
with some sort of club.
There's a fourth guy, Cole.
And now a fourth.
Oh my God!
The club off the head of the Undertaker.
The size of these guys.
Five men in masks in
big
the ring.
Very big men in
my God!
Choke him!
I guess this is the reward.
Choke him! Get the wire!
God, Cole, beating the daylights out of Undertaker.
The Undertaker being assaulted.
What the hell is that? His hand. What is that?
Oh no.
Oh my God.
Like a steel wire.
I don't know what it is. It's some case choking out Undertaker over it.
Choke him.
The Undertaker being brutally beaten here.
Choke him. I don't know if it's
rope or channel wire. I don't know what it is.
Undertaker struggling.
Oh my God, someone's got to get help here.
Choke him.
This is, oh my God. All right, someone's got to stop this guy. He's choking him out here.
I can't.
He's turning pink.
And that now Hassan.
Talk about a coward, huh?
The Undertaker's helpless.
Oh my God. Ever remember Undertaker. This, look at these guys on their knees, these thugs or whatever the hell they are with the mask, and they're all on their knees like.
This must be what Muhammad Hassan meant earlier tonight when he said Daivari was gonna be a sacrifice for a greater good, and that sacrifice would have its reward.
I think you're right, Cole. Hello, I think that's exactly what this is, but oh my God, the big picture here is...
I've never seen The Undertaker left like this.
No, the condition of The Undertaker. And now those guys, they grab the Daivari. Oh my God, look at this, they're holding him up. Like a sacrifice, like a, some kind of a...
Sort of...
Like he's a martyr or something, like you know
ceremony.
What I mean? Like he's a martyr.
Right.
I've never seen nothing like this in the industry myself, but this is a little crazy, weird. Got to get help out here for The Undertaker. I'm telling you, man, he's hurt.
Undertaker has no clue where he's at.
Wow. Muhammad Hassan will not take his eyes off of The Undertaker.
How about a transformation?
God, nasty.
Well, I'm still shocked at what happened moments ago here on SmackDown. It was The Undertaker against Daivari, but The Undertaker sending a message here to Muhammad Hassan, the Tombstone Piledriver. As Undertaker picked up the victory, though, Taz, we both questioned why Hassan didn't seem concerned, why he even had a smile on his face.
We had no idea.
Here is your winner.
Didn't know the fix was in either. But Muhammad Hassan, he knew, and this is the fix we're talking about.
You have five men in black masks attacking The Undertaker.
Yeah, big men, very large men, and look at this. Oh, my God, right across the head.
And that wasn't all.
It looks like some kind of piano wire or steel wire or something. Choke it out, The Undertaker. This is graphic footage right here. I mean, the man is getting choked out. It's hard to watch. He's turning different colors. You hear Hassan screaming, choking. And then this.
The camel clutch by Muhammad Hassan, adding insult to injury. Muhammad Hassan and these cronies leaving The Undertaker in a state that I've never seen him in before. I'll tell you, Taz, it was one of the most bizarre things I've ever seen. I've never seen The Undertaker left like that.
I'll tell you what, me, 17 years in this industry, I've never seen anything like that. Never seen more or less The Undertaker go through something like that. I don't know what to say.
Well, Muhammad Hassan ensuring that he is a player come the Great American
Absolutely
Bash.
Absolutely a player.
When he meets The Undertaker in that number one contenders matchup, the winner to get an opportunity at the World Heavyweight Championship.
My name is Thomas Whitney. Esquire. And I am the legal counsel for Mr. Muhammad Hassan. Mr. Hassan has authorized me to read this statement on his behalf. Mr. Hassan has endured so much emotional distress as a result of the vitriolic hatred he has encountered over the last week. As a result, he has chosen to take a leave of absence from SmackDown. I'd like to remind you that Mr. Hassan is as American as each and every one of you. He has the same rights and privileges under the First Amendment, including freedom of expression. And it is a sad day in America in which someone like my client has found need to retain an attorney to protect his fundamental rights to freedom of speech and freedom from discrimination. Like all other Americans, you should not be prejudiced against Mr. Hassan or his manager, Khosro Daivari. Therefore, my client will never again appear here on SmackDown. Until such time as he defeats The Undertaker at a pay-per-view ironically enough called The Great American Bash. And furthermore, my client will no longer be appearing on Sir, I do not know your intentions, but sir, need I remind you that I am not a wrestler, sir. I am an attorney.
Come on, take it. Wait. No, don't do that.
He's an attorney. Oh, man. Undertaker just chokeslammed Muhammad Hassan's attorney.
This guy's not a wrestler. I don't.
Oh, my God. Oh.
All right, someone's got to stop this here. Look.
Who's going to stop it, Taz? I mean, this is ridiculous. Undertaker made very well.
Oh, my God. No, no!
Not the tombstone pile driver.
No! No, no!
Oh, my. Say, Taz, that the Undertaker's crossed the line here.
I don't think he gives a rat's you know what about crossing the line. I'll tell you, Cole, I don't know how much money Muhammad Hassan pays his attorney, but it's definitely not enough.
I think Undertaker was upset that Hassan didn't show up himself here tonight.
You think?
He decided to use the attorney to send Mr. Hassan a little message that in 10 days at the Great American Bash. Well, you're seeing in the ring right now may be the fate of Muhammad Hassan. Wow.
Merciless.
Absolutely.
And I understand the disdain and hatred that Taker has for Hassan, but guy, he couldn't even defend himself. Damn it, he's a lawyer.
down in Baltimore tonight, still to come the JBL victory speech. But 2 weeks ago, Muhammad Hassan was involved in a major controversy. Last week, Hassan's attorney came to the ring to address the situation. We would learn that Muhammad Hassan would be taking a leave of absence from SmackDown until the Great American Bash.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Muhammad Hassan's personal attorney.
Mr. Hassan has endured so much emotional distress as a result of the vitriolic hatred he has encountered over the last week. Therefore, my client will never again appear here on SmackDown until such time as he defeats The Undertaker at a pay-per-view, ironically enough, called The Great American Bash. And furthermore, my client will no longer be appearing on...
Well, apparently The Undertaker had had enough of Muhammad Hassan's attorney. The Undertaker would confront this warrior in the ring.
Sir, I do not know your intentions, but sir, need I remind you that I am not a wrestler, I am an attorney.
So you were saying?
Well, I was saying that The Undertaker, what I was trying to get is that he crossed the line here. I mean, this guy is not a wrestler. This guy, I mean, Hassan's attorney just got driven to hell here.
Do you really think The Undertaker cared that he crossed the line?
No, I don't. I don't. And Muhammad Hassan, look at this. Pay attention to what happened to your attorney here, my man, last week. You got to deal with the dead man in a few days at the Great American Bash. I wouldn't want to be Muhammad Hassan.
This was a direct message sent to Muhammad Hassan by The Undertaker last week. Muhammad Hassan will be back this Sunday in Buffalo at the Great American Bash. We will find out who will be the new number one contender for the World Heavyweight Championship.
So much riding on the line. You get an opportunity to face the champion. This is big. Who's gonna end up on top?